Я блик это сейчас. Ты делаешь на весь экран сейчас?
Все. Я делал на весь экран. Всем привет. Там народ уже подтянулся. Там, думаю, ждать смысла нет. Скайп можно выключить, скажи. Он как бы сам меня вот на главном экране. И можно начинать.
Окей, Яэль, you can start the presentation.
Окей, great. Окей. So, great to be here and nice to meet you all. My name is Yael Kabili. I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a lawyer. I'm a lawyer both in the United States and in Israel. I have about 12 years of experience. I started in intellectual property, mostly patents, copyrights, trademarks. This is my core expertise, and in the last few years, I've been working mostly on e-commerce and, in particular, Amazon. I have two little boys, and another thing that's important to know is that I'm addicted to Amazon. When I used to live in the United States, I used to order packages all the time. I used to have like 3 or 4 per day reaching my apartment, so I know Amazon from both sides, and this is how I actually started getting into that field and got interested in that field. Today, what I do mostly, 99% of my business is about Amazon. What we do in my firm, we do suspensions, a lot of ASIN suspensions, account suspensions, and we also do registration of intellectual property, meaning trademark registration, copyright registration, searching if a certain product is covered by a patent. This is mostly what we do as part of the firm. So I'll tell you a little bit about what we're going to speak today. The purpose of this webinar is really to give you an idea of what are copyrights, what is a patent, how is it relevant to private labels. I know many of you are private labels. How do I avoid intellectual property violations? I know that many of you have received a suspension notice saying that they infringe intellectual property. What does it mean? And how do we prevent it? We're going to speak about what you do if you receive a warning letter from one of your competitors. We're going to speak about how to preserve your rights. Okay, you guys have a product. Many of you are private labels. So you have your brand and you want to protect it, especially from hijackers. We see a lot of hijackers lately. We're going to speak about trademarks and when it matters and when do you need to register a trademark. Many of you who encountered hijackers unfortunately received a response from Amazon that you need a trademark to remove them. So we're going to speak about that. And we're going to speak about a little bit about those of you who actually invented a product with a particular shape and who want to protect it. So I like to start with this. I don't know if you can see clearly from the video. So this is a notification that one of my clients received. It's about inauthentic products. Somebody complained that a product is inauthentic. We see a lot of these lately. Most of the sellers at some point get this suspension, unfortunately. But this is something you can bring back. This is something that I hope none of you will see. This is a notice about your entire account being suspended. So I hope that none of you will see it. And if you do what we say today, hopefully you won't see it. At least in the field of intellectual property, you'll know what to do. this is an example of a warning letter that one of my clients received, saying that he infringes a trademark and that he should stop immediately. This is actually a kind warning letter, because some of the letters are actually very aggressive. Please pay $100,000 or something like that. This one was actually nice. So we're going to start. I'm going to speak to you about the different kinds of intellectual property. Okay, most of you heard about patents. Some of you heard about copyrights. So there are four main things that you're going to see on Amazon. One is the copyrights. Okay, copyrights protect graphic designs. It protects texts and photos, okay? If you take, we're going to speak about that, if you take text from your competitor, if you copy his listing, you can be suspended. Trademarks talk about the protection of a brand, of your logo, okay? Patent, okay. Yes.
Денис? Маленький перевод. Она сейчас разговаривает насчет интеллектуальных знаков и патентов, трейдмарков, и как это все проверять. Она адвокат 12 лет в сфере патентов и Амазона и авторских прав. Окей?
Окей, so... I'll tell you the main thing that you need to translate, and we're gonna get to that. This is just just an explanation for the beginning. But so there are four things: copyrights, trademarks, patents. We see a lot on Amazon, and design patent. I'm gonna go and explain each of them, and we're going to start with copyrights. So those of you who are already here, this is one of the most important slides of this presentation. Many of you fall here, many of you lose your listing because of copyright suspensions. And the thing you need to know, okay, the thing you need to know is that graphic designs are protected by copyright even if they are not registered. Okay, so if you look at this, for example, this little bag here on the left, if you copy this design and you do the same bag with the same dogs, okay, it's very easy to remove your listing. Okay, so you can copy the bag and copy the idea of little dogs, but don't copy the exact dogs in the same colors with the same shape. Okay, same here. Okay, you can copy those, but don't copy the exact same thing. Okay, you can copy the idea, but don't copy it exactly, because they can remove you immediately. No need for a patent. Okay, so my advice to you, and I'm saying it a lot, but my advice to you is, first of all, not to copy graphic design, okay? Take your own designer. Pay your own designer. It's not so expensive today. If you know you want to have a scarf with dogs, then have your own designer design it, and you have your own scarf, okay? So that's one, and that's the most important, and many Amazon sellers don't know that, okay? Maybe you want to translate this.
Okay. Денис, сейчас разговор идет о авторских правах, как вот на фотографии слева, то, что там нарисована собака, и она говорит, что на данный момент лучше не копировать такие авторские права, а брать своего дизайнера и делать что-то свое самому, потому что это может закрыть лист сразу. Как на фотографии посередине, что выбираешь, допустим, тоже фотографию с собакой, не делать на своем продукте именно такую же дизайнерскую, авторскую фотографию. Ни в коем случае. Иначе закроют страницу полностью.
Yeah, so important things that you should not do, okay? And also because of copyrights. Do not copy an entire listing, okay? Do not take your competitor's listing and copy all the words or full sentences. You'll get suspended, okay? This is one. Second, don't take other people images, okay? Most of you know that.
Hello. Во-первых, не копировать полностью то, что написано в листинге у конкурентов, потому что это повлияет на закрывание страницы тоже. Okay, second?
Yeah, second is for the images. Just don't take images not from anybody and not from your supplier, okay? Sometimes your manufacturer will tell you, yeah, these are my images, you can take them and post them, but sometimes he himself took it from, you know, from another brand owner. So don't take from your supplier, just hire your own photographer.
Ни в коем случае не брать фотографии других продавцов или у своего поставщика, а просто нанять фотографа, потому что это приведет к тому, что закроют страницу, потому что сам поставщик ворует эти же фотографии. Okay, continue.
Okay, I mean, you can, again, as I said, you can copy the idea and get inspiration from someone, but just don't copy the exact same design that you saw on the other bag or whatever it is.
Можно взять как бы такую же идею, но не скопировать именно такую же авторскую идею, как у остального, у другого продавца.
So many of my clients tell me, you know, when they're suspended and they say, I don't even understand. Of course, I mean, I copied this design, but I took a designer and I made many changes. And then I look at it and for me, it looks exactly the same. I mean, there are minor changes, but you can barely see them. And I want to tell you, I mean, small changes are not enough. Okay, small changes are not enough. If you're basing your design on somebody else, you need to do a lot of changes. Okay, it's not enough to change like just the color or just a small, you know, a little bit of the shape. You need to do substantial changes.
Она говорит, что нужно сделать большие изменения в дизайне, а не какие-то маленькие, допустим, только цвет или дорисовать что-то, а чтобы совсем отличалось, чтобы не закрыли страницу. Okay.
Okay, so we're moving to trademarks. Trademarks protect names mostly, okay, your brand. It can also protect colors. This is, many people don't know that, but colors can have a protection. The duration of trademarks is unlimited. And for Amazon sellers, what you need to know basically is that you need to search and make sure that the brand you choose is not taken. Okay, this is something very important to translate. You can't just choose a name and that's it. You need to search and make sure that nobody took it. Otherwise, you'll be infringing a trademark.
Сейчас она говорит про торговые знаки и говорит, что есть торговый знак на цвет, на имя, на логотип и на номер. И нужно это все проверять заранее, чтобы не было проблемы с именем даже торговой марки вашего продукта. Okay.
So, as I said, so you need to search and make sure that it's not taken. Where do you search? You search on the USPTO, okay? USPTO. This is the website for the US trademarks. You search there and make sure you don't search only for your name, but also for similar name, okay? So if my trademark, for example, is Blendy with a Y, I would look for Blendy with I also, and for Blend, and for Blendy, because trademarks protect not only the exact same name, but also very similar names. Okay, so when you search for it, make sure you cover everything.
Она рассказывает про то, что нужно искать на сайте USPTO не только одно какое-то слово, которое связано с вами, Бренди, а еще всякие вариации этого слова, чтобы посмотреть, чтобы не попасть под торговый знак этого продавца другого, чтобы не было проблем. Окей.
So just you know, a few more tips. If you find a trademark and it's marked dead, many people ask me, if it's dead, it's not a problem. It means that the trademark isn't alive and it won't, you know, it won't stop you. And don't use a very well-known shape, like I showed here, this Lego here, it's actually a trademark. So for well-known shapes, sometimes they can be a trademark, so be careful not to copy well-known shapes.
Она говорит, что она, если есть торговая марка, вы ее проверили, и написано, что она мертва, то можно воспользоваться. Но есть торговые марки на форму, как на Лего, то, что вот здесь фотография есть, ее нельзя использовать, саму форму этого, как для продажи своего продукта.
Okay, so we're moving to patents. Most of you heard about patents. They cover inventions and technological processes. Many of you fall with patents on Amazon, and the question is always, how do I know if there's a patent? Okay, so we're gonna speak about that just in a minute. The last thing is design patent. Okay, most of you haven't heard about design patent. Okay, very important slide. When you as a private label, if you choose this product, the avocado protector here that you see, somebody may have protected the shape of this product. And that means that even if you put another label on it, okay, if I take it and I sell it on Amazon and I call it Yael Kabili, it doesn't mean that it's okay. If somebody has protected the shape, then I can be suspended. Okay, so when you search, you need to search for patent and design patent.
Она говорит, что есть, это очень важный слайд, есть патент на дизайн, как вот на фотографии здесь справа, это режет авокадо, и очень важно искать не только патент для самого продукта, но и для дизайна, чтобы не было проблем с этим, потому что нельзя будет продавать это. Окей.
So how do you search for patents? So it's very important to say that it's not an easy job, okay? Many people ask me, how do I know if there's a patent for the product that I sell? You'll never know for sure, okay? I can tell you, large companies, they pay lawyers thousands of dollars for, you know, for an opinion if yes or no there's a patent and if they can do a certain a product. So you won't do that, okay? Most of Amazon sellers don't do that. You want to translate that?
Она говорит, что много патентов, которые люди ищут, продавцы Amazon, они просто не ищут их, как большие компании, как они вкладывают много денег в это и пытаются найти ответ да или нет. Поэтому это очень тяжело найти ответ, как продавцам Amazon.
I'll tell you what you do.
Okay.
Yeah, so I mean, if you wanna decrease the risk, okay, if you want less risk, then do your own research, okay? I always say try to do your own research. It's amazing how many patents you can find on Google. Okay? So let's say now that I want to sell the Lego, okay? I wanna sell the Lego. I'm going to start with a Google search, okay? And I'm going to write patents Lego, okay? I'm going to write patents for Lego, and I'm going to see what I'm going to find. And really, when you type your competitor's name with the word patent on Google, you'll be amazed at how many times you'll find the patent. Okay, so start by searching on Google. Put your competitor, the one that you're going to copy, and see if you can find a patent just by searching on Google.
Одна из опций, как искать патент, это поставить имя своего конкурента, добавить слово патент, и в Google можно будет найти сразу много опций, оно выдаст по поиску, по серчу, сколько вариантов есть, если у этого продавца есть свой патент. Одна из опций, как искать. Окей? Okay? Yes, yeah.
Yes, I see that on the live, the slide that is shown is the first one and not the one that we're talking about right now.
No, it's Google patent.
Yeah. No, you can see it on the... Okay, it's not working. So as we said, first we do a Google search, a regular Google search. There's also a nice search which is called Google Patent. Google is actually has its own database for patents. So if you search on Google Patents, You'll also find, you can put your competitor's name there and see if you can find the patents. That's a nice tool also. I don't know if you know it, Rubik.
Google Patents, yes, okay. Еще одна из опций — это поискать Google Patents. Там есть вариация поиска, тоже по патентам, оно очень помогает. Это одно из следующих серчей. Окей.
Окей. And there's also the USPTO website. You can see here, you can search by the patent, you write your competitor name here, and you write here, you choose assignee, and you can see if this particular company, what patents they have. Of course, you don't know for sure, okay? You never know for sure, and it's very, you know, amateur to do it like that. But I prefer that you do it than not do it at all, okay? So it's better than nothing, I always say. Many things you can find just by searching on Google and Google Patents.
Окей, еще одна опция — это поискать на USPTO Patent Search, там ввести имя своего конкурента и поискать все патенты, которые есть на его имя. И это очень важно сделать и обязательно делать эти все поиски до того, как выбираете продвижение с вашим товаром. Окей.
Here's a situation that happens sometimes. You get a warning letter from someone saying that you are infringing his trademark or his design patent, and he tells you, if you don't stop, then I'm going to complain with Amazon. So what you need to do is, first, don't ignore it, okay? You want to try to say?
Да, yes. Она говорит, что когда вы получаете письмо, что вы нарушаете какой-то патент или трейдмарк, нельзя не привлекаться к нему и не относиться к этому серьезно, к этому письму. Okay.
Right. So first, don't ignore it. You need to deal with that, because if you don't, then he might remove your listing, and that's not good for your account. So first of all, don't ignore it. Try to research if indeed this person has a trademark, like he says, or has a patent. And if you can, just fix the problem, okay? So sometimes you're going to put on your listing, you're going to write a word, and you didn't know that it's a trademark of your competitor, okay? So if your competitor tells you to remove it, you remove it, okay? You don't want to have your listing removed.
Если вам прислали такое письмо, ни в коем случае не игнорировать его, а постараться поискать этого конкурента и решить с ним проблему. Даже может быть такое, что в листинге у вас написано какое-то слово, что этот конкурент сделал на него патент, и просто стереть его, оно вернет ваш листинг. И нельзя ни в коем случае не относиться к этому серьезно.
I don't understand much, but it sounds like you're doing a great job.
I hope so.
Yeah. When the listing is suspended, okay, nobody warned you and they removed you, it's not actually quite easy to remove a listing when you have a patent or you have a trademark. I've been working with large brands for years, and I've been doing that as well, and it's quite easy. You just fill out the complaint, you explain what's your trademark, and you explain how it's violated, and you remove the listing. And when it happens to you, the first thing you need to know is, is it true? Are you infringing a trademark? Are you infringing a patent? It's very, very important that you know that, because legally, if you are infringing, you can get a lawsuit. So you don't want to be selling it. You don't want to be reinstated. You don't want to be selling something that is infringing.
Окей, сейчас она говорит насчет листингов, что очень легко сделать так, что ваш конкурент подаст заявку в Amazon, что есть какая-то проблема с листингом вашим, потому что вы взяли патент или трейдмарк его, и к этому нужно отнестись серьезно, попытаться это решить и посмотреть, если можно что-то сделать, допустим, не продавать этот товар, или проверить, где у вас была проблема, чтобы вы не проверили, чтобы они вас не засудили. Okay.
Yeah, so so first, the first thing, as I said, is to understand this is where you usually need a lawyer. Okay, it's quite difficult to understand yourself if you're infringing or not. 99% of the people don't know if they're infringing or not, and they don't know how to search, right? So here you usually need a lawyer. So the first thing I do when people come to me is first to understand if there's an infringement, and second to understand if we can fix it. Okay, if the violation is that you have a trademark on the listing, okay, you can simply remove it from the listing, right? You can simply edit your listing and remove it. But sometimes you can't change it because your whole product is actually covered by a patent. So sometimes you cannot, you know, stop the violation or fix it.
Okay, этот момент самый важный, потому что тут уже нужно будет воспользоваться адвокатом. Если есть, допустим, в листинге какой-то трейдмарк, то листинг можно переделать и стереть это слово, которое на него есть, допустим, трейдмарк. Но может быть такое, что на сам продукт есть трейдмарк и патент, и его просто невозможно продавать. Тут она решает эту же проблему, и она знает, как к этому подойти. И самому это уже не решить, получается. Okay?
Right. So, if I see that we can fix the violation, we appeal to Amazon. If we can't fix it, we usually go to the other side, the complainant, and we try to, you know, to reach an agreement with them. Maybe you'll just finish your inventory. Maybe you can pay a certain fee for each product that you sell, and they'll let you finish your inventory or even continue selling.
Она говорит, что тут возможность такая, что она проверяет и видит, если можно подать апелляцию в Amazon, или можно поговорить со второй стороной, которая подала прошение, чтобы сняли наш листинг. Может быть, можно заплатить им какую-то часть денег, чтобы они разрешили нам продать весь товар до конца и больше не продавать его, или просто его распродать на другой стороне и договориться с ними, чтобы они нас не засудили и разрешили нам продолжить торговать другими товарами. Окей. Okay.
Yes, so somebody I see here is asking if a non-US citizen can make online registration on the USPTO without a patent attorney. Yes, anybody can file a trademark himself on the USPTO. It's not that easy for most people, but if you have time and you know how to learn those stuff, maybe you can try to learn that. So that's for listing suspensions. I mean, here I talk about mostly about listing suspensions related to patents. Okay, we have tons of listing suspensions not related to patents, but that's for another webinar, I guess. So I'm going to speak now a little bit about how to protect your rights. Okay.
Она маленько хочет сейчас поговорить, как защитить ваши права, авторские ваши права. На продукты. Okay.
Yeah, so many of you will invent something. Many of you will start working on a certain product, and then you get an idea, and you change it, and you come up with something completely different, and you're gonna want to protect it. So we were talking earlier about the, you know, the avocado protector. This can be a nice design patent. Okay, for example, this carpet can be registered as a design patent. You protect the shape of your product. Okay, this product too, it's actually registered and protected. What we see here, the graphic design, which is quite ugly, I must say, but so this graphic design can be protected perhaps by a copyright registration. Okay. You can also copyright your images. Okay. You can register your images. It's very cheap to register copyright and protect your images.
Okay. Она говорит, что как вы, как продавцы, когда-нибудь все равно придумаете какой-то новый продукт, сделаете для него новую форму, и можно зарегистрировать эту саму форму. Как на фотографии посредине коврика, на него можно сделать регистрацию формы. Или на фотографию справа, где на ней можно сделать тоже регистрацию формы самого продукта. Или на регистрацию на фотографию слева, где на ней бабочки, можно сделать регистрацию на цвет и рисунки. Это не очень дорого, на рисунке сделать тоже можно сделать свою регистрацию, авторские права.
You want to register a design patent, as opposed to a patent. A design patent is actually not expensive. Okay, everybody knows that patents are very, very expensive to register, but design patents are not expensive at all.
Все знают, что патент сам стоит много денег зарегистрировать, но на дизайн патент это не очень дорого стоит вообще и это можно зарегистрировать без проблем. Так что все, кто будет это делать, свой дизайн, можете зарегистрировать свой дизайн, а не патенты, но он будет стоить намного дешевле. Okay.
Many people ask me about trademarks. That's the most common question I get lately, especially since all the hijackers are going in on all the listings. So trademark registration is very different from brand registry, okay? So don't confuse it, okay? Many people think that if they do a brand registry on Amazon, then the brand is protected, and that's not true.
Сейчас она разговаривает насчет торгового знака и регистрации, и очень важно заметить, что brand registry на Amazon это не то же самое, как зарегистрировать товарный знак. Это две разные вещи совсем.
Okay. The only thing it gives you, the brand registration, is the fact that people cannot change your listing, okay? They can't change the images, they cannot change the wording.
Brand registry, оно влияет на то, что нельзя поменять фотографии и вас в контекст в листинге. Okay.
Yeah. So for example, if somebody starts selling the product on your listing, like those hijackers, or somebody takes your name and opens a new listing and uses your brand, there's nothing you can do almost nothing you can do if you don't have a trademark. And that's why many, many Amazon private sellers go and register trademarks. It's not very expensive. And the good thing about trademarks is that the minute you have, once it's registered, the minute you have an hijacker, you just, you know, kick them out of your way. It's very easy and very fast to remove them with a trademark. Yeah.
Когда есть торговая марка, это очень влияет на то, что у вас есть возможность быстрее избавиться от хайджекеров и от тех людей, кто могут открыть под вашим именем листинг и продавать контрафактные товары. Так что это влияет на то, чтобы ваш листинг был защищен, и вы были защищены на Амазоне без всяких влиятельных проблем со стороны хайджекеров. Okay?
Yes, the only problem with the trademark, I mean, the only thing is that it takes about 7 months to register. It takes a while, and as long as it's not registered, I mean, Amazon look at it, but they don't promise you anything. They don't promise you that they'll do something to remove the hijacker.
Торговую марку где-то берет зарегистрировать около 7 месяцев, и Amazon видит, что вы ее регистрируете, но они не обещают вам, что они что-то смогут сделать насчет всех проблем, как хайджекеров и остальных, пока нет окончательной торговой марки зарегистрированной в Америке. Okay.
And something that you should know that we see a lot lately, there are some scams, you know, people that they see your listing, they see that it sells well, and they notice that you didn't register your trademark. So what they do is they go and register the trademark in their own name, and they actually steal your trademark.
В последнее время появилось много обманов. Продавцы, которые видят, что ваш продукт идет хорошо, он продается классно на Амазоне, листинг хороший, все отлично у вас, они идут и делают трейдмарк на свое имя вашего продукта и просто воруют ваш листинг, и у вас становятся проблемы с ними.
Yeah, And the problem is that after they register the trademark in their name, they go to Amazon and they say that you are infringing the trademark, and they remove you from your own listing. They take over your listing because they registered the trademark.
После того, как они сделают регистрацию на торговую марку вашего продукта на свое имя, они обращаются в Amazon и просят, чтобы закрыли, потому что вы нарушаете права их, и в конце концов они, получается, забирают ваш листинг с вашим продуктом и со всеми вашими способностями, то, что вы пытались добиться всего. Okay.
Right. So, I mean, those that have, you know, a product that sells very well, I mean, many people are coming to me lately because they heard about what happens and they start protecting their trademarks. And this is, I mean, I wrote here the right timing. I think that if you just started selling and you don't know if your product is going to sell, I don't know if it's the right time to register a trademark, okay? I mean, you have a lot of expenses. I don't know if that's the first thing I'll do. But once the trademark, the product sells well and your brand becomes important to you and you don't want to have someone take it, so this is the right timing to protect it.
Она говорит, что когда продавцы продают хорошо и уже бренд поднимается хорошо, то лучше всего сделать торговую марку на свой продукт, чтобы не было проблем. Но как начинающий продавец, у вас и так много расходов, и нет смысла как бы вкладывать сейчас. Только когда уже начнется хороший рост продукта, продажи, все поднимется, лучше всего сделать торговую марку, застраховать себя и свой бренд, чтобы Amazon видел, что вы серьезно относитесь к этому, и у вас были все защищены, все гарантии для продажи в Amazon. Окей.
Right, so another question I get a lot is when do I use the TM symbol and when do I use the R symbol? I'll tell you something interesting. You can use the TM symbol right now, okay? All of you can use the TM symbol right now, even if you haven't registered your trademark. This just means that it's your trademark. TM means non-registered trademark. And the R symbol means that it's registered. Okay, so once you finish the process, you can switch to R. Okay.
So I can use now TM in my product?
Yes, yes, you can. Yes.
Okay. You can. Она сейчас говорит. Она сейчас говорит две очень важные вещи. Писать букву TM на своем продукте можно сейчас до того, как вы сделали регистрацию трейдмарка, а букву R писать только когда вы уже сделали и получили все разрешения на трейдмарк. So we can now write the TM symbol in every product that you have in Amazon
Registry. Yeah, but don't put it in the title of your listing, okay? That's not allowed. Amazon don't like it in general. The symbols, they don't like it at all. But I mean, most of the people who do trademark, they put it somewhere in the description, bullets, or anywhere else.
Окей, это можно писать в description или в буллетах, но не в тайтле, самое главное. Потому что Amazon это не очень любит, он любит, чтобы была уже окончательная запись его трейдмарка registration.
Okay. You see here, this one actually put it in the title. I mean, what they do, they won't remove your listing because of that, but they sometimes they remove the symbol, okay? They tell you that you shouldn't. So don't put it in the title. But you see here, I mean, it's not only good to protect yourself from hijackers. Many people, many buyers, when they see that, they actually think that you are the original, okay? They think that you are the original and all the others are fake.
Okay. Она еще раз говорит, что вот здесь продавец поставил трейдмарк уже в title. Она говорит, что лучше всего туда не ставить, потому что Amazon его просто стерет, и сам знак буквы R, и лучше перенести его тоже в другое место. И некоторые продавцы будут видеть, что вы как бы оригинальный продавец этого продукта. Ну, лучше писать его в буллетах и в description. R и TM. Okay. So the R and TM we write on only in the bullets and in the description, not in the title at all. No title. Okay. Не писать в тайтле R и TM.
They won't kick you out of Amazon, but you shouldn't do that.
Лучше этого не делать. Окей, don't do it. Окей.
Do you wanna take questions, or I mean, this is more or less what I wanted to talk about. In terms of the services of my firm, we do ASIN reinstatement, account reinstatement. We do trademark search, trademark registration, copyright registration, design patent, and you know all the protection that you need. We handle warning letters and negotiations with the complainants. Okay, so if you have if somebody complains against you, we turn to the other side and we try to negotiate a deal. We do agreements with your manufacturers. We do agreements between partners, and we do patent search. As I said, I mean, most people don't do a patent search, and they do it themselves because it's not. I mean, this is not very cheap.
Okay, your service, она делает восстановление. Yes. Okay. Она делает восстановление эсинов, восстановление счетов, поиск трейдмарк, регистрацию трейдмарк, и регистрацию патентов, регистрацию дизайн патентов. Она делает также помощь в основном в письмах предупреждающих, что есть проблема, и все, что связано с решением этих проблем. Делает договора с поставщиками и делает поиски патентов, которые люди в основном не делают. Она этим занимается. Окей. И поиск патентов, он тоже не очень из дешевых, чтобы вы знали заранее. Окей.
Alright, so you wanna try to read the questions?
Окей, Денис?
Да, я понял.
Окей, okay. Хочешь какие-то вопросы задать? Анна хочет вопросы.
Сейчас давайте сначала зайдем в этот в Skype. Сейчас посмотрим, какие там текущие. Сейчас я настрою здесь.
Wait a second. Шняя я любудек кошелек.
Mm-hmm.